So we're here at Golfers Green. This is where the protest is happening. This is the nerve center of the protest against the current government here in Sri Lanka. As you can see, it's a Friday evening. It's still busy. It was threatening to rain all day, but people have still turned up. In fact, it was raining for a couple of minutes. Nevertheless, people have not gone home or fled away. They're still here. And we're going to speak to a few people, especially some of the people, the volunteers who then run the stalls. There'll be people who donate food or donate money or some sort of resource. It could be books even. We will see a public library as well. So, and all of this, by the way, is happening in a very, very peaceful manner. So far, there has not been much aggression. There has not been any hostile action from the protesters. And this movement has been gathering pace since the 9th of April. And it's still peaceful. So now let's talk to some of the sponsors, some of the volunteers of this movement to see why they do it, how they keep going, are they tired? Have they faced any intimidation, and how they managed to keep this protest going so peacefully, and what their end goal is.
I've been here for an odd 9 or 10 days because I've been coming and going because I have schoolwork and I have to manage both of that. So I've been coming and going. So roughly about 10 or 9 days.
And since you've been here, have you ever witnessed any violence or aggression? Things becoming hostile, basically.
That's the beautiful thing about this protest. So everybody knows that the government has many tricks up their sleeves, and people are being smart this time and not letting them pull those tricks. If anybody sees somebody trying to cause violence or anybody acting in an obscene manner, intoxicated, people stop it. Like, the people come together and they stop the violence and they break it, like they stop it immediately where they see it. So that's a beautiful thing about this, and I haven't witnessed any violence so far.
And any challenges that you face or anything?
There's a lot of harsh weather. It's hot some days, it's raining and pouring some days. And of course, there are people that are trying to sabotage, and there's a lot of ups and downs in this, but the people are coming together and pulling through. We're receiving tons of donations from so many generous Sri Lankans, and I'm thankful for that. Even through all the obstacles and challenges, we're going to pull through and we're going to receive our demands, and we're going to send Gota home.
What do you mean by sabotage, if you could clarify that? Or what do you suspect, or has there been any reason for you to say that?
We've suspected that there have been attempts of food poisoning or adding laxatives to water so that people would get sick, that people, protesters that come here would get sick and not come back here. So we've received rumors about that, so we are trying to be as responsible as possible, collecting the data of donors and being responsible about what we do here.
How many hours a day do you spend here? Do you come here every day, or
if I come here, it's very rare of me to go back home. So usually everybody here is functioning on less than 2 or 3 hours of sleep. So it's amazing. Like, everybody here is just volunteering. We're not gaining anything. We're all here representing Sri Lanka. We're here for our motherland.
Okay, it has now started to drizzle. It's now started to rain here, but there are people still here. It has started to rain here. So as you can see, this is where it gets really, really loud. Very, very loud. And it's drizzling a little as well. On the opposite side of the road, there'll be protesters as well.
You are a famous artist, actress here in Sri Lanka. People, so many well-wishers come here and tell you that you're doing a good job. Why are you supporting this?
This is my duty. We must have to do this. This is not a support, actually. This is our duty. That's it.
But you know, you don't have to do this. You don't have to support it. you can move to another country if you want to. All of that is there. So why are you doing this?
Like, yes, we can. Everybody can move. If you have money, you can go any other country, very proper country, Europe or wherever. But the thing is, this is my motherland. Everybody has an idea, and everybody has love, and you know, it's a very bond. So to being a Sri Lankan, so that's why I am here. So I born here, and I studied here, and I did my higher studies here. Time to time, I went out of my country, and I came back because I really love this country. That is, we are called it Sri Lankan, proper Sri Lankan. That's it.
Since when have you helped or volunteered to help the people here, the protesters here at Galface? Have you been doing this since day one or recently? Or how?
No, not recently. Actually, I started these protests a long time ago. So I talk about this environment, I talk about this country, and I talk about this economy, and I talk about these industries and all. So it's a long time ago I talk about these, all those things. Now it's happening here. So the people came out, people means youngsters came out. This is the right time came out, these people. So I'm so happy about that, because if somebody stays in silent, I think it's not the right thing to do. We have to talk about this, and we have to fight to rights. That is the important thing. So this is the right time to fight.
What is the main goal, ultimate goal of all this?
So yes. We have few goals. Goals mean we need a proper country. So proper law, that's the important thing. We don't have proper law. So, and 20th Amendment, it's not the right amendment in this country, because it's they're building up one family like Rajapaksas. So it's focused on their needs and stuff. So everybody knows in this world now, they robbed this country. We need our money back. So we have to prepare the law and logistics and the lawyers and the engineers and doctors. Everybody must have to come together to fight this. That is the important thing in this moment.
Are you afraid of any retaliation from anyone for supporting these protesters or anything like that?
We don't have any doubts, you know. So we have to work for one goal. Now we are going to the goal. We have to achieve it. That is what we have to do in this moment. I'm proudly say thank you so much for my youngsters. They are very forward, and they are very energetic, and they are very powerful. So we can achieve this.
So we're here at the stall called the Public Library here at the Gota Go Village. Now, even all of this is just voluntary based. It was created by one person named Chamal, and then just many other people just started joining in. So if I could just show you who is here. These are all volunteers. If I could just show you. Like all these people that you see, they are all volunteers, and they come to help. They come to help out, and Even the stall that you see, the tents that you see, people come here and ask, you know, what do you need? What more do you need to keep this movement going? And when the volunteers say they want something, whoever can help them will pitch in and provide the tents. And even this wooden rack you see here, this was also voluntarily donated by someone. Now, these are not necessarily big companies or big people or even politicians, just general citizens of Sri Lanka who will donate even something as simple as a wooden book rack. So how do people keep track of all the books here? Well, they have a seal, and they expect people to just return the books. So nobody is necessarily held to a certain standard or said, you know, you have to return the book, but people are expected to just bring their books. Once they read them, return it so that someone else can read as well. So there's a lot of food being prepared here.
This is love from Melbourne, okay. Because there's no any, what do you call, how do I say, there's no group here, there's no political party, there's no personal, okay, there's no anything such as, how do I say, personal agendas. This is few friends. So the boat you saw for Melbourne, like Love for Melbourne, this we got few funds from our friends from Melbourne, Canada, and who works here. Right now, I'm a fashion designer, and she's a model, and he has his own auto model system. That is Zenny. Who knows? It's a singer. So it's kind of a unity. We are doing it. It's not anything to make anything like, you know, get publicity or anything. It's just an encouragement to people to come here and stand with us. That's all. Not anything else. There's no any other motive.
How long have you been here? When did this start?
This is like our fourth or fifth time, because we will go out a little bit time off to get fun. I know, get everything done. But so many negative things comes around. But we don't care. We're gonna do this until, because I win, you win. We can't win alone. We all have to win. So this is for Sri Lanka. Whoever gonna see this, I'm telling you, back home, or whatever you're doing, we all standing for us and standing for you guys too. That's all.
So what's the main goal? What's the main objective? Why are we doing all this? Why are you doing all of this?
See. Okay, that's now very deep one. All right, see, why I do this here is for, okay, it sounds again selfish, but I'm doing for myself. As a Sri Lankan civilian, I haven't got anything from this government free of charge, unless my IDNT and driving license and my education. Even get my driving license and my IDNT, these guys made my life hell out of it. And up to now, I pumped for my vehicle, everything, fuel or anything, I pay everything. But the Ceylon Petrol Corporation is on lost. Like no one, you know, like we didn't get any credit, and no one pumped fuel for free. But today, yesterday, I pumped about 33 liters for 10,800. So I don't want to do this, and no one deserve this. So I'm doing this for few people who shouting over there or come here and making a voice against it. Just a refreshment, few food. That's it we can do.
Isn't it tiring?
I'm fasting, by the way. I'm on the fasting month, but for the love of my country, I'm gonna do this until we're gonna build.
So this would be one of the efforts to keep the place clean. As you can see, this is a stall saying zero plastic, and they encourage people to throw away the plastic bottles in an eco-friendly way, or at least return them to this stall so that it can be disposed of in an environmentally friendly way. As you can see, these are two volunteers working inside the stall, and they're collecting the plastic bottles separately. And what appears to be everything that is not plastic bottles going into the box.
Hi, so we've been out here for the past 14 days. I think today is the 14th day. We've been coming in, and by we, what I mean is the youth. They've been coming in, running this tent. Not one faction, but a lot of people come in here. They volunteer their time, even with work and all of that. They come here because we want a change. We want a change here, and we want these Rajapakshas to resign. We want the 20th Amendment to be abolished, and we do want a new system. We want a system change. So that's why all of us are here day and night trying to get this change. So what we do in the stall over here, it's run basically by donations from all the people that come here. There are various people who donate various things. We don't take any monetary donations. What we take in are either food items, water, biscuits, items that we can give the protesters and the people who wait in the gamma itself. So we try to avoid plastic, but unfortunately we don't have an alternative to water bottles because we mainly get them in plastic over here. But we try our best to put out the message. Today's Earth Day also. So we stress on the fact that, you know, if you take a water bottle, there are refilling stations. You can go refill your bottles. We encourage people to bring their own steel bottles or refillable bottles. And we also tell them not to dispose of it on the ground. There are dustbins all over the place. We have people working throughout the day who dispose of things. So I feel like for a protest that has been going on for 14 days, we have been having a pretty clean environment, because we have to remember that this is not a very a small protest. It's a protest that has been going for days. And I think in that way, I'm pretty proud of how the people have been disposing of things. And I hope that people will remember this even after the Gamma disperses and we get the change we are fighting for.
Gamma, can you explain what Gamma is, the village?
Yeah, so by Gamma, what I mean is a village. So basically how this started over here was, it started very small. There was no tents, there was nothing. It began with just people protesting with slogans and signs. But slowly people started coming in. The difference here is we don't have one person leading everyone over here. It's different people coming in and taking their own leadership and doing certain things. So compared to even any other village, we see more development within this village that was put up 14 days ago. There's solar power here. We run on solar power for a few hours. And other than that, there's a lot of other, there's a stall that does recycling for all the plastic that comes out from here. And also we have a lot of people just like looking out for each other and telling each other, look, don't drop the plastic, put it in a bin. So I think it's a strong message going out over here. There's a lot of activists related to the environment as well who come here and tell us and inform us that, you know, look, we need to do better. Even if it's a protest, we need to remember that, you know, we can't litter. So I feel like everyone's doing their part and really contributing to make this as sustainable as possible.
What about law enforcement? Can you feel like you've been threatened by police officers or something like that?
To be honest, so far they have been helping us. We've had a few instances where, you know, there's always instances where there are a group of people who come in here and try to profit off this, steal water bottles, steal certain items to sort of sell. But then the law enforcement have really helped us with dealing with them in a professional way rather than just like pulling them out. So in that way, they've really helped us. We help them too. So it's a two-way thing. So hopefully we see more of the law enforcers, the forcers, all of them joining our side, because we really need their support at the end of the day. We can't do this alone. We can't win this a fight alone. We need everyone's support.
How do you manage to organize this? Like, how do you organize this? I mean, is it through social media that you get volunteers and you spread the message that you want more food and water? How do you do that?
Mainly what we do is, so there's a group of youth that we come, like almost every day we take shifts and we come in here. And also, like you said, we put it out on social media. We say, look, we need volunteers to stay between this time. Is there anyone willing to come? And the overflow of like love and support we get, it's so overwhelming. Even with donations, all of the people just come up to me and they're like, you know, what can I give? How can I give? Can I give you some money? And then we tell them, look, we don't take money. We need transparency over here. So because of that, the best way to do it is through your rations and whatever that you give us, because we give it back. The people give it to us and we give it back. We're just the distribution point over here.
So who volunteers? Is it students, like university students?
It's a lot of young people, but also I'm not going to say that it's just the young. There are mothers and fathers who come here after work with their kids, and all of them help. So it's a family affair at the end of the day.
So ma'am, can you explain why you are doing this and what is this stall about?
So yeah, so this is the Teach Out stall. So why we decided to do this was, we thought there were many people who were coming for the protest and they all had this question. Okay, we protest now saying Gota go home, but what happens next? If there is a vacuum, whether who could replace him, or whether in the constitution, whether there is provision for that. So there were a lot of questions. So people started searching for answers. So we felt this was a good time to reach out to people, as to explain to them in simple layman language what the constitution says, what are the provisions that they have, and also what would be the end result by people coming and protesting here, what can they demand for. So we thought we will have a teach out tent here and do some teach out sessions, and also like have information around so that they can just come, read, engage, and also learn things by themselves.
So how long have you been here? When did you set up this stall?
Yeah, so the first day we set it up on the 15th of April. So yeah, from the 15th we have been having this till today.
How has the response been? Like, do people come here to learn more?
Yeah, so we have had good response. So people also like not just only for teach out session, they just come engage with in conversations. So we had people like that's why even today this session we decided to do, it was something that came from the people who came and had a chat with us, and they said, can we have this kind of thing, can we do more? Like, so there are suggestions, there are lots of questions, and people, we could see a great engagement, and people are in need to know more. So we have seen a good response in that sense.
Why do you do this? See, it must be difficult. You have to take time out of your job, out of work, and it's tiring. Like, why is this important to do? Why focus on this?
Yeah, so one reason why we thought is, one thing, because our people were not so, people were ignorant when it came to political decisions and decision making. They always looked at very short term focuses and only made their decisions. So as a result, we have come to this place, and where we are today is because of that. So we have always been thinking of creating awareness among people to show like why, when they choose their leaders, what are the things that they should look for, what are the changes that the country needs. So these kind of things, only a very few people in certain sectors always raised their voice, but rest of the country was like very happy in their little bubble. Until it affected them individually, they never asked these questions. So we always wanted people to question everything, ask questions, hold people accountable, hold your leaders accountable. So this system was not here. So I know there are lots of gaps even in our systems, but also our idea is to encourage people to know, and so that they will also hold their leaders accountable and answerable, so that the leaders also feel that pressure, which we kind of see that happening now.
What if, have you ever thought, we are putting in so much effort, you are putting in so much effort, what if this is not successful?
Well, I think by now we have achieved like small victories. We have got small victories,
such as
the reshuffling of, not that it's a great thing, but like even for the cabinet to be reshuffled, and also the ministers are feeling the pressure. They can't even come out, including the president. So these people's voices have put a lot of pressure. So in that sense, we feel if we had started this earlier, it would have been much better, but it's nevertheless never too late. So we hope that this pressure will also put pressure to abolish the executive presidency, to repeal the 20th Amendment, so things like that. But this is the good time, because of the pressure, we could see these changes can be done in the future.
Can you tell me a bit about the challenges of running this stall, like getting these loudspeakers, the electricity, the people you need to run this stall? Can you tell us a bit about how you get these resources?
Yeah. So we are, of course, we are all volunteers. We all have our full-time jobs, and we come and do this in the evening. So like a few of us were passionate about doing something. So just like within 24 hours, we had to set up everything. So we just started with whatever we had. We just hired the equipments, put up a tent and started on. Then we had few friends who helped us out to, who hired the equipments and chairs for us. So that's how, and helped us with printing off banners. So just that, about 3-4 of us got together, and then we had others who came and volunteered with us.
From Colombo for The Print, this is Regina Mihindukula Surya.